الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. A great you all with the greeting of Islam. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. A great you all with the greeting of Islam and I welcome you all for continuation of our series concerning الاختيارات الفقهية. الإمام الألباني رحمة الله عليه by Sheikh Ibrahim Abu Shadi. Today inshallah we have a new segment number 17. This is point number 25 concerning حكم تكبيرات الانتقال. The ruling about the takbir saying Allahu Akbar when you're moving from a position to position during the prayer. Imam al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi selected the opinion that this is a must due to the fact hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam صلوا كما رأيتموني أصلي. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam say, pray like you saw me praying. So Sheikh Al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi is saying, a person who consider the takbir during the salah moving from one position to the other to be a sunnah or recommended is wrong, due to the fact that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he ordered the person who badly pray, he taught him to say Allahu Akbar moving from a position to position. As it came with Imam Shawkani in his book Nail al-Awtar, then in his book Sail al-Jarrar, that the originality of all the orders of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that he gave it to the man who pray badly to be a must. Also Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal rahmatullahi alayhi had adopted the opinion of a must for the person who making salah to say Allahu Akbar moving from position to another position is a must and not a optional. Point number 26, حكم سكتات الإمام ومحلها. The ruling concerning the silence of Imam and its places. Imam al-Albani rahmatullahi alayhi is saying, adopt the opinion that when the Imam remain quiet after reciting the Fatiha, giving a chance for the followers to recite the Fatiha, say this is a bid'ah, innovation in the deen. That because nobody had conveyed this information to us from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. All what we got is that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had remained silent in two places. The first time when he entered the prayer after he making takbiratul ihram, the first takbira saying Allahu Akbar. And he used to remain silent because he will make dua al-istiftah, the opening dua, which came in hadith Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu. As for the second silent after he finished reciting the Quran. And this most the statement or the saying of those people who said so, but we could not rely in this information because it is munqati'a and it have defect in the isnad, as the Sheikh Al-Albani rahmatullah alayhi had explained this in his book Irwa'ul Ghalil. So, taking the above in consideration, that there is no solid, authentic, or formation, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had remained silent in the beginning of the salah and after recitation of the Quran. The only authentic thing is that he made one time after takbirat al-ihram. Other than this, he did not give a period to remain silent. So the first one was only for making the du'a al-istiftah after entering the salah. With this we come inshallah to conclusion to this segment, understanding that the Sheikh has selected the opinion that saying Allahu Akbar, moving from up to down, going from down to up between the two sajda, this is a must, is not optional. The second opinion that the Imam or the reciter of the Quran in Salah, he will remain silent only in the beginning so he can make dua al-istiftah. But for the Imam to remain silent after Fatiha for purpose giving a chance to the followers to recite the Fatiha, this is innovation in the deen. We ask Allah to direct us to the correct understanding about His deen and give us and enable us the ability to follow the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. آخر دعوانا أن الحمد لله رب العالمين. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك، أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت، أستغفرك وأتوب إليك. And Allah knows best.